In today's class, we are going to understand how to search for a given number in an array. In an array means, when you see programming, you have a one-dimensional array and two-dimensional array. Here, array means, we are writing assembly language program, but why we are given as an array means, for your comfortness, I'm given this. In the memory location, we are having some data. And in the given data, we are searching for a particular number. And when we want to search a particular number, whether the searching number is available in the corresponding memory location or not. Let us say there are five numbers. Let us say there are five numbers which are stored in the data memory locations 20, 21, 22, 23, and 24. So in this five elements, we are searching for one element. Let us say the number 22. Which number need to be searched? We are interested to search for a number 22. So I am going to store the first data as 11. Going to enter the second data as 22. Given the third data as 33. Fourth data as 44. Fifth data as 55. So let us have 11, 22, 33, 44, and 55 as the five data. So now I am naming it as data 1, data 2, data 3, data 4, and data 5. The 25th location, we can see number of occurrences. If we are searching for the number 22, means number of occurrences of 22 is how much? So only one occurrences. So the answer is 01 in the 25th location. This is what we are expecting to do. For this, we are going to write the program. And our interest is number of occurrences is 1. So out of 5 locations, 22 is in which location? 22 is in 21st memory location. So in 21st memory location, there is 22 available. In the next time, if we are giving this 22 here, what will be the data memory location 25? The answer is 2. What will be the content of 26? And what will be the content of 27? In 26, we will be having 20, and in 27, we will be having 21. So if all are 22, this is the best case. You can say if all are 22, this is the best case. If all are 22, this is the best case. Now, what will be the content of 25th memory location? So in the 25, the content of 26 is 20, 27 is 21. What about the content of 28? 22, 23, 24. This is what we are planning to do in a program. So this we can write a Python program for this. We can write a C program for this. We can write a C++ program for this. We can write an assembly language program for any processor like this. But our interest is to write an assembly language program using ADP microcontrollers. So first step, what is our first step to do? Register to store number of elements. Number of elements is 5. அப்போ we need to store, we need a pointer. நம்ம எப்படி C program pointer பண்றோம், pointer to point the starting address of the memory location. Starting address of the memory location அப்படி சொல்றோம். So there must be a pointer. Pointerங்கிறது என்ன, ஒரு register இருக்கலாம். Let us say R0 is the register. R0 is the register which can point the starting address of the memory location. For example, in the 26, 27, 28, 29, 2A. This five locations, the 22 is available. 26 அப்புறம் 27 இன்கிரிமெண்ட் பண்ணும், 28 இன்கிரிமெண்ட் பண்ணி அந்த கன்சிகூட்டிவ் லொகேஷன்ஸ்ல நம்ம டேட்டா இருக்குதுன்னு சொல்றதுக்காக ஒரு பாயிண்டர். லெட் அஸ் சே தி பாயிண்டர் இஸ் R1. எப்படி சி ப்ரோக்ராம்ல பாயிண்டர்ல யூஸ் பண்றோமோ அது மாதிரி R0 கேன் பி யூஸ்ட் அஸ் அ பாயிண்டர், R1 கேன் பி யூஸ்ட் அஸ் அ பாயிண்டர். அண்ட் ரெஜிஸ்டர் டு ஸ்டோர் நம்பர் ஆஃப் எலிமெண்ட்ஸ்னா, இப்போ R0 R1 முடிஞ்சிருச்சுன்னா இப்போ R2 வச்சுக்கலாம். நம்பர் ஆஃப் எலிமெண்ட்ஸ் 5 அப்படின்னா, ஸோ R2 கேன் பி யூஸ்ட் டு ஸ்டோர் த number of elements. So there is a need for R0, which is to point the starting address of the memory location. There is a pointer to store the number of occurrences location R1, and there is a register to store the number of elements. To search for the given number in an array, which instruction must be used? Okay, there is an instruction called compare. So let us go to the data sheet. And you can see there is an instruction called compare. Compare and jump not equal, these are all the instructions which is used for comparing. So comparing the, here you can see there is an instruction to
compare the content of the accumulator. There is an instruction to compare the content of the accumulator with the immediate data. So there is an instruction to compare the content of the accumulator with data address. There is an instruction to compare the content of the memory location pointed by R0 with the immediate constant. There is an instruction to compare the content of the memory location pointed by R1 with the immediate data. And there is an instruction to compare the R0 content with immediate data, register R1 content with immediate data, register R2 content with immediate data, register R3 content with immediate data, register R4 content with immediate data, like this, register R5 content with immediate data, like that, it goes on. And along with compare instruction, there is another jump not equal. There is another attachment called jump not equal. Compare and jump not equal. So if it is not equal while comparing, if the content of the accumulator is not equal to the immediate data, then jump to the specified address, that is code address. If it is not equal, jump to the corresponding location. If it is equal, then go to the next instruction. Here you see, compare and jump not equal, A comma, data code address we can use, or we can use this. Because we are using register R0 as a pointer, we can use this instruction. So it is not necessary that always you must use this instruction. Compare and jump not equal R0 comma, data code address, something like that, we can use the instruction. So the instruction which we can use it is compare and jump not equal at R0, because R0 is pointing the memory location, right? Because R0 is pointing the memory location now with the immediate constant. Is there a comma? Compare and jump equal at R0 comma data hash data and code address hash 22H comma, say for example some loop X. Loop 1 means loop 1, let us say loop 1. Compare and jump not equal at R0 comma hash 22H comma loop 1, something like that. We can use this instruction. What compare instruction normally do? It will do subtraction. There is immediate constant 22 is subtracted from content of R0. If equal arrange is 0. If 0 arrange appadina, so loop 1 la enna pannalam, if it is not equal appadina and compare match aga vendidilla adu vittralam. Ipo equal appadina vechukom, equal match aichu. Appo match aichuna enna pannanum, nam instruction enna enna instruction eladanum, edho or register increment pannanum, edho or register increment pannanuma illaya. அப்போ இன்னொரு ரெஜிஸ்டர் நம்ம வச்சுக்கணுமா இல்லையா? ஆர்டு வச்சுக்கிற மாதிரி இன்னொரு ரெஜிஸ்டர் நம்ம வச்சுக்கணும். இப்படி நம்ம கோடு இப்படி எழுதலாம். எழுதுறதுக்கு எப்படி கோடு எழுதுங்கிறதுக்கு நான் அப்படியே உங்களுக்கு சொல்லி தந்துருக்கேன். ஸோ அப்படியே ஃபாலோ பண்ண முடியுதுன்னு பாருங்க. இப்போ இன்னொரு ரெஜிஸ்டர் என்ன பண்ணிக்கணும், நாலாவது ரெஜிஸ்டர் டு ஸ்டோர் நம்பர் ஆஃப் அக்கரன்சஸ், நம்பர் ஆஃப் அக்கரன்சஸ். அது வந்து என்ன ரெஜிஸ்டர் வச்சுக்கலாம், R3 வச்சுக்கலாம், R3 வச்சுக்கலாம். அப்போ நாட் ஈக்வல் compare and jump not equal to loop 1 அப்படி சொல்லிட்டாங்க. not equal to loop 1 equal இருந்துச்சுன்னா என்ன பண்ணுவோம், அந்த loop 1 ஜம்ப் பண்ணாம கீழே வரும், அடுத்த லைன் எக்ஸிக்யூட் பண்ண வரும். அடுத்த லைன்ல என்ன பண்ணலாம், நம்ம இன்கிரிமெண்ட் R3 எழுதிக்கலாமா, இன்கிரிமெண்ட் R3 ஒரு இன்ஸ்ட்ரக்ஷன் எழுதிக்கலாம். you can write an instruction called increment R3. அந்த நம்பர் ஆஃப் அக்கரன்சஸ் எந்தெந்த நம்பர் லொகேஷன்ல இருக்கணும்னு நம்ம சொல்லியிருக்கிறோம். இன்கிரிமெண்ட் R3 அப்படின்னா நம்பர் ஆஃப் அக்கரன்சஸ் எத்தனை டைம் அப்படிங்கிறது இங்க இருக்குதா, 25th மெமரி லொகேஷன் அது இருக்குன்னு சொல்லிருக்கோமா. அப்ப MOV 25H கமா R3 மூவ் 25H கமா R3, தட் இஸ் R3 கண்டென்ட் நீட் டு பி மூவ் டு த 25th மெமரி லொகேஷன். தட் மீன்ஸ் வாட், ஆஃப்டர் இன்கிரிமெண்டிங் திஸ் தென் யூ சி இட்ஸ் வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட், அண்ட் த லொகேஷன் ஆல்சோ ஷுட் மூவ் டு த நெக்ஸ்ட் லொகேஷன், 26th லொகேஷன். இன் விச் லொகேஷன் தேர் இஸ் அ மேட்ச், தட் லொகேஷன் ஆல்சோ ஷுட் மூவ் டு த நெக்ஸ்ட் லொகேஷன், ரைட்? ஸோ currently we are addressing the memory location pointed by R0. currently we are looking at the memory location pointed by R0, hence the content of R0 is the address. Yes or no? The content of R0 is address of the match. So we can write an instruction MOV 26 அல்லது MOV அல்லது இப்ப என்ன பண்ணலாம், move at R1, A. Okay, because only from A1 we can use the pointer operation. That's why we are using moving the content to the accumulator and then moving. Now what happens? R1 is pointing what? We should make the R1 to point 26th location. Should make the R1 to point 26th location.
and in the 26th location we will get the 20, and then we can increment one, and then the loop one can come here. That's all, no? That's all. Then loop one can come here, and here we can check for decrement jump not zero. There is an instruction called the decrement jump not zero. So decrement jump not zero or two, say for example loop two, something like that. Loop two, that loop two has to come somewhere over here. So with this understanding that what we have so far, we can write the code. Starting address is ORC 0000H. After that, what is the first instruction? You can see move R0 comma 20H. So register R0 is pointing the starting address of the data memory location. So R0 is used as a pointer to point the starting address of an array. So this is the first instruction. Then what is the next instruction? Move R3 comma hash 00H. So there is a register called R3, which is initialized with the immediate constant 00 to store the number of matches. Okay. So there is a semicolon and we return some small comments. So this is called comments. So what this instruction is being used for, that is being understood by using the comments. So when writing the complex programs, we can write the comments to make us to understand. So the first instruction is to point the starting address of the data memory location. There are five elements are there in an array. The array starting address is 20. So R0 is pointing starting address of the array, which is this. Then R3 comma 00 means to store the number of occurrences R3. So R4, which specifies the number of elements in an array. So the number of elements in an array is 5. So move immediately. Hash means immediate. Move the immediate constant 20 to the R0, move 00 to R3, move immediately the 5 to R4. Okay. Then R1 is moved with 26. So match data location pointer. So 26, from 26 onwards, you have to store the match register location. So R1 is used as a pointer and R0 is used as a pointer here. So there are four registers which are being initialized, and we are using the compare and jump not zero instruction. So compare and jump not equal. Compare and jump not equal at R0 comma hash 22 H comma loop 2. So compare and jump not equal with the content pointed by R0 is not equal to 22. So if it is equal means it will come down. The content of R0 means it is address. The address has to move to the accumulator, and the accumulator content must be moved to the number location pointed by R1. So what is R1? R1 is match data location pointer, and increment R3, because there is one match, hence the R3 has to be incremented, and it has to move to the 25th number location, because that location will have the number of matches. And increment R1 to point to the next address, and increment R0 for receiving the next content from that array, because R0 is a pointer, and decrement jump not zero R4 to loop 3. So R4 is already 5, right? Because the number of elements in an array is 5. So it is decremented to 4. So because it is not 0, it will jump to loop 3, and then it will compare the R0 content. Now R0 content is what? R0 is incremented 21. So 21 is compared, the content of the memory location 21 is compared with 22. Then again it will do the operations. Content of, then again increment is R0 22, like this. This loop will execute for 5 times, and the 5 elements in an array will get compared with 22, and if there is an occurrence, it will do all the necessary operations like this. If there is no, if it is not equal, the jump to loop 2, just like that, it will increment R0 and it will jump back to this 2. This is how you need to understand. If there is a match, then only this 5 steps need to be done. If no match, if it is not equal, then it can jump to the loop 2, and then it can do the necessary operations like this. So then you can finally move the matches to the 25th location, and then you can halt the program by start jump halt. Okay. So let us execute this program. Let us execute this program in a better way. So already we are very much comfortable with this program. We have tested it very clearly. What I can do is control C, control V. So control copy and control paste in the Kale IDE. So in the Kale IDE, I have made everything ready by having the searching program like this. The compile, build, and rebuild all to check for zero errors, Fantastic. Going to debug. Start stop. So let us assume all the instructions will be 00. Move R0, 20H. R0 will be having 20H. Now you see R0 will have 20. So 20 memory location, 20 unit. All are 0. So number of match is also 0. So everything 0 should come, right? R0 is move the immediate constant 20 to R0. So 20 is moved to R0. Then move the immediate constant 00 to R3. So 00 is moved to R3. And 5 is moved to R4. Yes, 5 is moved to R4, which is number of elements in an array. And 26 is nothing but the starting address of the match address location. So R1 is moved with 26. And we are comparing a jump not equal at R0. R0 is pointing 20th memory location. 20th memory location contains 0. So the content of the memory location pointed by R0 is 20. So content of the memory location is 20 is 00. So 00 is compared with 22, and there is no, it is not equal. 00 is not equal means it has to jump to loop 2. So now the program execution has to jump to the loop 2 location. That is 12th location. That is what our interest. Let us see whether it is jumping to the 12th line. Yes, it has jumped to the 12th line because it is not equal. Incrementing R0. So you can see increment R0. R0 will increment to 21. And decrement and jump not 0 R4 comma loop 3. Decrement and jump not 0 R4 comma loop 3. Now R4 is 5. You see, observe carefully, R4 is 5. So it will decrement first. It will decrement R4. So R4 will become 4. And if it not 0, it will jump to loop 3. So 5 minus 1, 4. 5 minus 4, 4 is not 0. Hence it will jump to loop 3. Now we are expecting the program execution to jump to the line number 6. So decrement, jump not 0. R4, decrement R4, if not 0, jump to loop 3. This is a conditional jump instruction. So far we have seen only the unconditional jump instruction. Here we use the conditional jump instruction. So decrement jump not 0, if not 0, jump to the location loop 3. So now it is not 0 because you see R4 is 5 now. After executing this instruction, R4 will become 4. And because not 0, the program execution will point to the 6th location. That is what we need to observe by executing this instruction. You see, single step. So program execution has come to 6th location and R4 has become 4. So R4 is decremented from 5 to 4. And because it is not 0, the program execution jumps to loop 3. And what is R0? R0 is pointing 21. So content of the memory location 21 is 0. So 0 is compared with 22. So it is not equal. Hence it will jump to loop 2. You see, hence it will jump to loop 2. So again, it is incrementing R0. Why it is incrementing R0? To point to the 3rd location. Then R4, decrement jump not 0, R4 to loop 3. So R4 is 4. When decrement it becomes 3. So it is not 0. So it again it will jump to loop 3. Yes, it has jumped to loop 3. Then again it is checking R0 is pointing 22 now. So content of the memory location 22 is compared with the data 22. And it is not equal. Hence it will again jump to loop 2. It again jumps to loop 2 and it is incrementing R0 to point the next location. Decrement jump not 0 or R4. So the 4th time we are comparing and then increment R0 and the 5th time you are comparing and decrement R0, always 0, everything is 0. Then now you see R4 is 1. Now if you decrement R4, R4 becomes 0. If not 0, then only it will come to loop 3. Now the condition fails, right? Now the condition fails, you see, now the condition fails. So decrement jump not 0 R4 to loop 3. Now R4 when it is decremented becomes 0, so it will come down and execute the 14th line. That is what we need to observe here. Just come down and execute in the 14th line and it is halted. Program execution is halted. So now randomly we will fix some location. So in 24th location, let me keep it as 22. In 24th location, let me keep it as 22. In 24th location, I am just giving the value 22. In 24th location, I am giving the value 22. Am I right? Now we are going to execute the code. Okay, now we are going to execute the code by resetting. It comes to the first line. So R0 comma 20H, R0 will be loaded with 20, R3 is loaded with 00, very good. R4 is loaded with 5, please look at the screen. And R1 is loaded with 26, very good. Now you compare and jump not equal at R0. At R0 means you are 20. 20 to the location contains 00 and it is not equal, hence it will jump to loop 2.
and again it is incrementing R0. R4 is getting decremented, and then again it is coming to the low 3. So 21th location is 00, again it will do this. 22nd number location is 00, again it will do this. 23rd number location is 00, again it will do this. Now it's very interesting. Please try to understand, R0 content is 24. Please look at the screen, it's very important. R0 content is 24. So 24th number location contains data 22. So 22 is compared with 22, because R0 is pointing 24th memory location. In 24th memory location, the data is available 22. When it is compared with the immediate constant 22, it is equal. If it is not equal, it has to jump to loop 2. If it is equal, it will come to the next line. Now it is equal now, because 22 is matched with this 24. So if it is equal, so many things we need to do. What we need to do, we need to store the address. So R0 is having the address of the match location. Hence, the address has to be moved to the accumulator, you see. It will come down first because it is equal. Hence, R0 content is moved to the accumulator. So 24 has come to the accumulator, you see. 24 has come to the accumulator. And the accumulator content is moved to the memory location pointed by R1. So R1 is pointing which location? 26th location, you can see. R1 is pointing 26th location. So content of accumulator is moved to the 26th location. So content of accumulator is 24, which is the address of the match location. So that will move to the data memory location 26. That is what you have observed here. So 24 is the data memory address where the match found. So it is 26. And increment R3, because R3 has to say number of occurrences. Number of occurrences is 1. So 1 occurrence, that occurrence is available in the 1 match. That match is available in the 24th location. That is what being informed. Then you are incrementing R1, which is pointing to the next location, and incrementing R0. And decrement R0, R4. R4, which decrements, because it is 0, it has gone to the next line, and then it falls. So number of occurrence is 1, which is available in 24th location. Now we are adding one more 22 in the 20th number location. And we are resetting the code, and I am doing this once again. Now you see, the first location itself, quickly if you observe carefully. Now I have resetted the code and I have changed the 20th memory location 22 and 24th. There are two occurrences, two compare matches. One match is in the 20th memory location, another match is in the 24th memory location. Okay, so that we are expecting that in the output by executing this code. So move R0, 20H as usual, move R3, 00, move R4, 5 and R1, 26. All are updated. The first instruction itself is matching, right? Is becoming equal. So compare and jump not equal at R0, 22. Now at R0 is pointing 20th memory location. In 20th memory location, data 22 is available. Data 22 is available. So 22 is compared with immediate constant 22. Because it is equal, it will never jump. It will come down. Please see, come down. So R0 is 20. It is moving to the accumulator. This accumulator has 20. That is moved to the memory location pointed by R1. So R1 is having 26. So 26 will have 20, which is the first match location. Okay, first match location, incrementing R3 and moving that R3 25th memory location. One match, the first match is in the 20th memory location. Then again increment R1 and increment R1 and increment R0, decrement jump R0, R4, command O3. So this will continue, and then we can see other three times it will not match, the fourth time it will match, and then we'll get the answer, and then we'll pass the program. You can see now there are two occurrences. First occurrence is 20 and second occurrence is 24. In the 20th memory location we have 22, in the 24th memory location we have 22. That is what you observe. And finally we'll make everything as 22. All the five locations are 22. Now we'll see what happens. So instead of, now we are familiar with all the codes, now the familiar with all the instruction. Instead of going for single step execution, there is something like run, as we normally do in our C programming. There is run. Simply we can run the code and then we can halt the code and we can check the answer here. So there are five occurrences. You can see 25th memory location contains number of occurrences, number of matches, 5. In which location? In 20th memory location, 21st memory location, 22nd memory location, 23rd location, 24th memory location. Now these five locations, 22 is available. So randomly I am removing one data and then I am resetting and then I am running the code and then I am stopping. Now it's very easy, right? Number of occurrences is 4, which is in 20, 21, 23 and 24. 20, 21, 23 and 24. 22nd year merit as 0. Merit as 24 as 0. And I can make another. This is 0. Now only two occurrences, 21 and 23. Let me check. Reset, run, halt. So 21 and 23, two occurrences. And making everything is 0, 0, 0 occurrence. No address. You can see. Reset, run, halt. 0 occurrence. This was the previous answer. So 26, 27, 28, 29, and all is the previous answer. But you see number of occurrence 23 shows 0, 0. So it is mandatory for us to clear this also because people should not misunderstand. Otherwise, if 25 is 0, 0, it is not necessary to look at the next location because 25 shows number of matches. So the search number is not in the array, hence it is not necessary to look at the location of the match location, something like this. It goes on like this, sir. I hope you understand, and sorry for taking so much time. There is a conditional jump instruction like decrement jump not zero. And this is one of the million ways of writing the program for searching the number in an array. If you are good in assembly language programming, you can write some more better program, much better than this. So you can increase the array or decrease the array by using the corresponding R4 content. If I want to increase the array means, you can make this as 6 or 7 or etc. And based on that, the program will run. Okay. So practice makes perfect. So when we practice, we can become much familiar on this. Here it is only number search. The alphabet search, everything is happening in the Google search engine. So searching process starts from here and it ends at Google search engine. So through voice based it is being searched, through alphabetic order it searched, through alphabets it searched. It searches only the numbers. So we have written the code only for searching the numbers. So thank you, and I hope you enjoyed the searching.